I am new to this whole manifesting realm. I didn't really understand what it was or how you do it. I know I was told that manifesting is ultimately thinking of what you want and putting it out into the universe to start attracting it into your life. And I got to a point where I started thinking, you know what, it doesn't hurt to try manifesting. And if you want to know more about how to manifest or the restrictions and guidelines around manifesting, check out the video. I'm going to post it right here. Steph and I made a video before, and Steph is the manifesting queen. But when I was starting to manifest for the first time, I learned some things along the way. I'm going to share the 5 things I wish I knew when I was manifesting for the first time. Now, I'm going to use an example of a puppy and use that as something I'm referring to when I talk about manifesting an object. So the first thing to know is you do not have a personal genie to grant you a wish.
Rule number 1, I can't kill anybody. Rule number 2, I can't make anybody fall in love with anybody else. Rule number 3,
I can't bring people back from the dead.
So just because I want a puppy does not mean that I say, I want a puppy, boom, and it magically appears. That's not how it works. Trust me. If that is, I would have 1,000,000 puppies by now. The reality is that things take time, and it's not going to come right away. You do have to be patient, and you do have to give up control. It sounds kind of weird and counterintuitive. However, I realized that when I put into the universe that I wanted a puppy, I was attracting a puppy to me faster. And this also leads me to my next point. Don't have a timeline. Be patient. You're going to get your puppy when the timing is right. Yes, you want a puppy right now, and yes, it would definitely make a huge difference in your life and ultimately change your life for the better. However, you have to trust that the universe knows when the best time for you to get a puppy is. Your puppy is going to come to you when the timing is right for you. When I had a date on, you know, manifesting this puppy, when that day was approaching, I started getting that doubt of, I don't think this is gonna happen. And I feel like that prolonged it even more. But when that day came and went and I didn't have a puppy, I was heartbroken. I thought I was going to do it. I thought that if I had a date and what I wanted, I would make it come true. That's not the case. So just be patient during this process. Manifesting is an emotional process. Oh my goodness. I can't tell you. I have cried more times since manifesting than I have cried in probably the past 10 years. It is unreal, the emotions I felt. There was literally one day, as soon as I woke up, I was in full-fledged tears and angry about all these little things I didn't know I was angry about, and all these people that apparently pissed me off at one point in my past. And when I was doing that, I didn't know why this was coming up. But then I reached out to Steph, and Steph was super excited. Steph told me, this is just part of the process. You have to let go of things that are holding you back. And clearly, with what you're trying to manifest, these things are going to stop you from getting there. So the fact that you're very emotional and you're angry, that's telling me that you're dealing with those blocks that are going to prevent you. By you being emotional, you are getting yourself one step closer to actually getting your puppy. And I've got to be honest, even those days where I was so angry and so frustrated, the next morning I woke up with more energy and more determination than I've ever felt. And I felt like those releases ultimately made me so much happier. Number 4, don't get caught in a daydream.
I'm lost in a daydream, dreaming about my bundle of joy.
This was my downfall. I got so excited about the idea of having a puppy that I just got lost in a daydream and started thinking of what life will be like with a puppy, and I forgot everything else. I didn't want to do anything else. I literally just wanted that puppy so bad, and it ultimately distracted me from what I was doing. I've also realized that when you're caught in a daydream, you're living in a fantasy. So by living in that fantasy, it's actually taking longer for you to actually get what you want, because you're no longer taking those steps towards actually getting a puppy. You're living in your own little fantasy world. I am definitely a daydreamer, and this definitely slowed me down. When I was stuck in that daydream, I forgot about the purpose of what that puppy actually meant to me. When I started thinking about the symbolism of what that puppy actually meant, things started to come clearer and faster. Sometimes I felt like when I was daydreaming, I was becoming very selfish, and it was just, well, I want this, I want this, I want this. That's not how it works. Number 5, there are different ways to manifest. Now, this honestly blew my mind. When someone told me that they were manifesting, I didn't know what that meant. And I ended up talking to someone that wasn't Steph, and they told me, this is how you manifest. They told me that what they did worked every single time for them. And I was so excited. So I started their process, and I followed it to a T. But then I realized something's not right. Something's not clicking to me. I know some people have a dream board. So some people have photos that represent what they're trying to manifest, and they put it up on a board as a visual reminder of what they're doing. Other people have Pinterest boards, potentially. For me, what I discovered was that writing a Dear Universe letter was the best way for me. Now, what do I mean by a Dear Universe letter? Essentially, it was kind of like a diary entry. I would start a letter to the universe and say, Dear Universe. I would talk about what I'm trying to manifest. I would include the reasons why that puppy would mean a lot to me. I would talk about the emotions I was feeling, and even asking for the strength to help me get through that time of not having a puppy. I mentioned how I don't have a timeline on it, and how I know that the puppy will come when it is best for me. Manifesting is extremely powerful, and I feel like once you learn how it works for you, then anything is possible. I know for me, starting with a puppy was a big thing to start with. And again, this is just my example. I wasn't manifesting a puppy. But when I started off with something small, even when I was having a bad day, and I started with Dear Universe, and I would talk about the day and what was going on, and just needing that support or a sign or something to help me get through that difficult patch, it literally happened immediately. I literally finished the letter, and all of a sudden, all these positive things were coming my way. It started off with something so small, and I realized that what I was manifesting was so big that it was going to take time. So that one time where I did ask for something small, I got results right away. And that was just a great sign to show me that what I was doing was working. So ultimately, you have to find a method that works best for you. You have to find a way that you can be vulnerable. Manifesting is a process, and there is no right way to do it. But these are things that I've learned while starting out as a beginner that no one told me about or warned me about. Luckily, I had Steph there to reassure me that all of that is supposed to happen. So I just want you to know that if you're trying to manifest something and it's not coming to you right away, keep this list in mind and use this moving forward. We do have a blog about it, so if you want to read more about why all of these steps are important, make sure you check the link in the description below. Thank you so much for joining me again today. If you like videos like this, make sure you hit that like button. We would love it if you would subscribe. And if you want to be notified of every time we release a new video, make sure you hit that little bell notification. Thank you so much, and we'll see you again next Saturday. Bye!